Summit 2017 by IIM Raipur. I am Ankit Biswas, Executive Member of Media and Public Relations Committee of IIM Raipur, and we are privileged to have Dr. D. V. Shastry, Executive Director, Human Resource Department of GAIL. Sir, we welcome you and we first of all thank you a lot for sharing your insights and your experiences with the students of IIM Raipur.
Thank you, Ankit.
Sir, I would like to start off the discussion by asking you that in this rapidly digitizing world, where humanization of machines is the priority, do you think there is a risk of dehumanization of actual human resource, especially by the private sector companies?
Well, that is only an apprehension. To my mind, I think that there is no replacement of human beings. And perhaps to call human resources, the word itself is wrong. Resources, something like natural resources, some physical item, that is a resource. But human beings are simply human beings, so they cannot be replaced. Yes, the research and development and modernization is going on in each field, industrial equipment or artificial intelligence. Everything is developing, no doubt it should develop. But I don't think that any machine would be possible to run without human intervention. That is why in the most modern programmable logic controllers also we have the HMI, that is human machine interface. So without human being, and moreover, above all, what for these machines are there? They are for the benefit of the mankind. So it is the human being which is controller, not the other way around. Technology, it cannot become the master of human beings. So therefore, I don't think, yes, the physical effort which otherwise was being put into a particular operation until date, it will get reduced, so people can concentrate on doing better jobs. Whatever time is saved, whatever effort is saved, that can be utilized in a better manner for higher order kind of activities. But role of human beings can never be eliminated from any of the processes. So I don't find any danger to the mankind because of modernization of machines or digitization or whatever.
And sir, then in the industry we see that there is an upsurge in the startup culture, entrepreneurship culture. So, and again it is seen that the HR part of the business is being somewhat ignored by these companies. So is there any advice or any insight that you have in on these sectors and what should be done actually?
Basically, to my mind, nobody can knowingly or unknowingly cannot afford to ignore HR. Somebody may be following the HR process without knowing about it, because even so, whether it is startup or a family business or a job, principles remain common everywhere because human factor is common to all. Whether it is a grocery shop, whether it is a startup. Yes, startup is a good culture in our country because our own philosophy says Uddhyamena Purusha Simho Mupaiti Lakshmi Daivena Dei Mitika Purusha Vadanti. That means the one who is enterprising in nature, only he gains the wealth, only he gains the success. So until now people were focused only on seeking jobs in some organization, but now that there is encouragement to startups by the government of India also, by modifying the framework, by encouraging the entrepreneurs, so it's a good thing. And even if it is a single man show, HR element is inbuilt, because even if the owner of the business is a single man, that business is existing in the society only, it is not in isolation. So when the person deals with other human beings, human factor is there. And yes, if it is a very small organization, 3-4 persons, formal HR department may not exist, but principles of HR are there. Motivation theory, nobody can ignore. Unless you motivate anybody, how you will expect the best output? You talk compensation and benefit, it may not be there in a structured form, but for everything you have to pay a price. Nothing is without a price. Even if somebody does a favor to someone else, it is with some motive. It is perhaps only the Almighty or the parents who do everything for the children without expecting anything in the return. But otherwise, every other thing is a transaction in this world. So it will be misnomer to say that there is no compensation and benefit. Even if it is aggregation of 2, 3 or 4 or 10 persons, all the principles apply. Leadership, out of 5 all cannot be leaders. So there will be some leader who will either emerge or by definition he is a leader because perhaps he has put in the financial capital or whatever. So there will be a leader, there will be managers, there will be followers, there will be team members, there will be customers, there will be stakeholders, everything, whether it is a micro level startup or a big industry, principles and framework remain the same. But yes, the manner in which the processes are applied to a particular business, depending on its size, it will keep varying. But there is absolutely no doubt about the fact that fundamental principles of HR are applicable at each and every place as long as even a single human being is existing with that entity.
Now sir, for our future managers who are looking to build a career in the resources, natural resources in industry, so what sort of particular industry skill sets do you advise them to have or them to develop to be prepared for the industry?
I would say that your formal education enables you to acquire the knowledge of a particular domain, whether it is engineering or law or medicine, whatever. But if it is in a natural resource intensive organization or otherwise, core competency is the necessary condition. But the soft skills, the interpersonal skills, the qualities of heart, not the head, those are more important for anybody to become successful in any organization. You take whether it is an institute like IIM or it is a shop in a mega mall or it is doctor's clinic, even you find that now the professional corporate chain of clinics is there, like you Clo Dental, you find, or many like Shana's beauty parlor franchises are there. Everywhere it is the soft skills, because even best of the service provided without human touch or without humility or without the objective of customer delight, it will never grow the business. However competent you may be, but if you don't possess the soft skills or behavioral skills, I can tell with guarantee that that kind of person will never achieve the real height. He may go up to a certain level in the ladder. So whether it is natural resource intensive industry or it is a production line or a textile industry or one's own startup consuming natural resources, basics precondition is core skills should be mastered and one should keep updating. But more important is dealing with people, influencing the stakeholders, building the teams, empowering the teams, and executing with courage. Whatever vision or strategy you have in your mind, you should have be courageous enough to execute that. And for executing that, you need to change the things. So driving change is another competency which you should have. And effective communication should be there, because best of the intent, unless communicated properly, has no meaning. So these are some of the soft skills which should be possessed by the people to achieve great heights.
And so finally, we would like to know how your experience of the Leadership Summit has been and whether you have any suggestions for us to take this forward in our future ventures.
Well, it's a wonderful initiative, and I must thank the organizers for organizing such a wonderful event. Particularly, if you are talking from convenience point of view, this scheduling of the event on Saturday and Sunday, it's a very good idea, because people like me who are otherwise not able to join such events is this only, because during working days it's next to impossible for us to move out of our normal business. But yes, if it is planned in this manner, perhaps one can think of managing the schedule. And in fact, your Professor Sanjeev Parashar has been after me for the last 2-3 years to call me to this campus, but because of this problem only, I could not make it, and now that scheduling was in this manner, I could make it, and I'm really impressed with the quality of students and the quality of faculty at IIM Raipur. They are doing a wonderful job, and I wish all the faculty and all the students a grand success in their endeavors. Thank you.
And sir, we thank you a lot for sharing your experience and insights of the industry, and we really hope that you will give us another chance to for doing the same.
My pleasure, it will be my pleasure, and whenever, wherever you find, wherever I can be of help, it will be my pleasure to extend my helping hand to you.